Hey, it's Pastor Dan from Dexter Gospel Church with a Proverbs Practical. I appreciate you watching. Today we begin to look at a series of Proverbs about justice and judgment. We're in Proverbs 24, verse 23. Proverbs 24, verse 23 says, "These things also belong to the wise. It is not good to have respect of persons in judgment." This is one of the most fundamental principles of justice in the Bible. It starts with the character of God, it's explicitly expressed in the law, it's urged to the wise, and it makes up a part of the authentic Christian life. There is not supposed to be any respect of persons in how we deal with other people, particularly in justice and judgment. That is, everyone should receive exactly the same treatment under the law, no matter what ethnicity they are, no matter where they're from, no matter how much money they have, no matter their past deeds, no matter their position in society, no matter their age, no matter their fame, no matter anything, everyone should be treated equally in justice. Some actions are right, some actions are wrong. Some behaviors are against the law, some are not. If a behavior is against the law, it doesn't matter who does it, they should be punished for it. If a behavior is not against the law, it doesn't matter who does it, they should not be punished for it. While justice may and probably should take circumstances and situations into account, especially when setting penalties, it should not take personage into account, who a person is. Anytime one person gets different treatment than another, simply because of who they are, injustice and folly are operating, not wisdom and justice. This is always a tension in government and in ruling. This is written to a man who will be in government, may even be the king himself at some point, handing down the final word on judgments and decisions. There would perpetually be the temptation to give preferential treatment and issue pardons to supporters, but to enforce the law strictly or punish harshly when it's someone from the opposition. There would always be the inclination to give the position to the family member or the friend, rather than to someone unrelated and unconnected, but maybe more qualified. But this kind of thing where people are treated differently because of who they are or who they know or what they've done in the past, it always leads straight into corruption. It creates and reinforces factions and divides. It breeds resentment and discontent. Injustice invariably leads to instability. We live in a day when we can see both this tension and its outworkings constantly, as questions are raised about whether the black gets the same treatment as the white in the court, the police officer as the citizen, the rich as the poor, the supporter of whomever is in office as the opponent of whomever is in office. Even the perception of the respect of persons is destructive to the stability of the society. So the wise leader, the wise human being, determines not to judge someone based on anything about them but what they have done or not done. The church refuses to give advantage or preference to the rich over the poor, the socially important over the seemingly unimportant. The wise will look to the unchanging, absolute nature of God for their guidance rather than the shifting, unstable alliances and advantages of man. It is never good to have respect of persons in judgment. I hope this video is a blessing to you. If it was, give it a like and subscribe to our channel for more like it if you haven't already. We'd love to see you in person here at Dexter Gospel Church, and we'd love to hear from you in the comments too. Until next time, I hope you stay well and treat people equally.